So in this video, we're mainly going to focus on complementary angles, but I want to talk just a little bit about supplementary. Complementary angles. Complementary is if you sum the two angles together, angle A plus angle B, you're going to get 90 degrees. Okay, so two angles that are acute, when you add them together and you get 90 degrees, we call those complementary. Two angles A plus B, if we add together and we get 180 degrees, those are supplementary. Now, how do I remember the difference between the two? Complementary, so COMP, blah, blah, blah. Look, guys, this is so cool. It's 90 degrees, right? So I just put a little thing right here and I got 90 degrees. How about that, right? Isn't that so cool? Okay. And then supplementary, it gets even better, right? So supplementary. How does supplementary work? So supplementary is 180 degrees. Oh my gosh, it's right there, right? So you can turn complementary into 90 and supplementary into 180. So now you'll never forget it, right? The Clark way, huh? Okay. So let's talk about right triangles, okay? With a triangle, there's 180 degrees is the sum of the interior angles of a triangle. So, sum of interior angles of a triangle. So, if I have a side A, then opposite that side is the angle capital A. If I have a side B, opposite that side is the angle capital B. And then if I have a side C, opposite that angle is a capital C. If this is 90 degrees, though, guys, if that's 90 degrees and there's 180 total, how do I figure out how much is left between A and B? Well, it's 90 taken away from 180. So if 90 degrees is used here, that means A and B together have to add up to be 90 degrees, meaning that those are complementary angles. Okay? So let's run with that idea here. And I'm going to do this sine. Let me do a different color. So I'm going to do the sine of angle B. What is the sine of angle B? Well, that's opposite over hypotenuse, right? So opposite over hypotenuse is little b over c. Okay? Little b over c. Now, what is the complement to angle B? That's angle A. If I add those together, I get 90, right? So that tells me. Okay, so the complementary, all right, so sine, it's the cosine. The cosine of angle A is what? It's adjacent divided by hypotenuse, B over C. So it's the exact same thing. Okay, let's do another one. The cosecant. I'm sorry, let's do it like this. All right. So the secant of angle B, what is the secant of angle B? Secant, well, that's the reciprocal of cosine, right? So the cosine of angle B is adjacent over hypotenuse, so the secant is C over A. Okay, so that's C over A. Well, what is the function that goes with its co-complementary for secant is the cosecant. Okay, it even sounds right. It's the cosecant. So the cosecant would be A here. Okay? It's Sure. A and B are complementary. All right. Now let's do a couple more. The cosine of angle B. The cosine of angle B is A divided by C. A divided by C. And this is equal to the sine. Well, sine, to get A divided by C, it needs to be dealing with angle A. Okay? Angle A. And then the secant of angle A. Sorry, let's do this. The cosecant of angle B is equal to, well, angle B, that's opposite over hypotenuse. So the hypotenuse over opposite for a cosecant, that's C over B. So related with B, the cosecant, the cofunction is the secant. So that's the secant of angle A. Okay? And the last one is the tangent and the cotangent. The tangent of angle B is opposite over adjacent. So opposite over adjacent. And so the cotangent of angle A is adjacent over opposite. Okay? So those are the same thing, cotangent A. Right? And then lastly, the tangent of A is equal to A over B, which is the cotangent of B. Okay? All right. So complementary angle theorem. Okay, the complementary angle theorem says cofunctions of complementary angles are equal. Okay, cofunctions of complementary angles are equal. So sine and cosine are cofunctions. Tangent and cotangent are cofunctions. And secant and cosecant are cofunctions. So what does that mean? So if I had like the sine of 30 degrees, okay, this is equal to the cosine of, well, if they're complementary, right, they add up to 90. So if one is 30, the other has to be 60. Okay, so 60 degrees. And so like if I had the tangent of 40 degrees, then that would be the same as the cotangent of 50 degrees. Okay? And then last, if I had like the secant of 70 degrees, that would be the same as the cosecant of 20 degrees. All right? These add up to 90. These add up to 90, right? And then your sine, your cosine, tangent, cotangent, secant, cosecant, right? So if they're complementary angles, then the cofunctions are equal to each other, okay? So kind of interesting fact there. So using the complementary angle theorem, the sine of 62 degrees is equal to the cosine of what? Well, it's 90 degrees minus 62 degrees, which is the cosine of 28 degrees. Okay. The tangent of pi over 12 is equal to the cotangent of, well, it's got to add up to 90 to be the complement, right? So pi over 2 is my radian mode minus pi over 12, which equals to cotangent. And then if I get the same denominator as 6 pi over 12 minus pi over 12 gets me 5 pi over 12 cotangent. So I've got cotangent 5 pi over 12. Okay, and last, if I've got sine squared 40 degrees plus sine squared 50 degrees, okay, so how can I figure this out? Well, one thing that's useful here, okay, if I apply, I can apply the same thing, even though it's squared, it's still the sine of 50 degrees, all squared, right? So the sine of 50 degrees is actually equal to the cosine of 90 minus 50 degrees squared, which is the cosine of 40 degrees. Why is that useful? Because now this is equal to the sine squared of 40 degrees plus the cosine squared of 40 degrees. Well, it doesn't matter what's in here. If it's sine squared something plus sine or cosine squared the same thing, that's always going to equal 1 by our Pythagorean identity. Okay? So be careful with those co-functions, all right? One last theorem that I want to make sure that we're dead set on, okay? So solving right triangles, right? So right triangle, if I've got a right triangle and it looks like this, okay? And I've got some angle A, some angle B, and some angle C. So that's little a, little b, little c. Okay? We got to find the missing sides. We know what? What do we know? A squared plus b squared equals c squared, Pythagorean theorem. But we also know angle A plus angle B has to equal 90 degrees. They're complements of each other. So we can use those properties. Okay, so we can definitely use those properties there. All right.